Welcome to weather instrument, which is called a rain gauge. I'm going to take you through what happens or what type of measurement is done by using instrument, which is a rain gauge. Now, rain gauge is an instrument which helps us to measure the amount of rainfall, total amount of rainfall in a day, or it is used to measure the amount of rainfall or precipitation, because sometimes it can rain hail, it can rain snow, drizzle, but so actually to be specific, it is an instrument used to measure precipitation in a weather station. Rain gauge has some characteristic or specification. Now, standard rain gauge, the reason why we call it a standard rain gauge is because it has some measurement. One, the diameter of rain gauge should be 13 centimeters. That means if you put a ruler across the mouth of the catching point of the rain gauge, it will give you a distance of 13 centimeters. Now, when you install it, it will be 30 centimeters above the ground. So from the ground to the top part of it, it is 30 centimeters. And then you install it also should be 15 centimeters below the ground. So as I can use this one to demonstrate, the height of a rain gauge should be actually 45 centimeters. And when you are installing, the 15 centimeters should be below the ground, and then 30 centimeters above the ground. So when it is not installed, it is this way. And when it is installed, it becomes now like this one. Weather instrument, as we said previously, or as it is known, is that instrument of weather should be the same all over the world, so that it can reflect global condition. Rainfall in other countries can be related to rainfall in other countries by using standard measuring instrument, because a condition whereby somebody will use a different diameter rain gauge or the different height, we are not going to get the correct readings. Now, for us to get correct reading, that means all instruments in the meteorological station are standardized. Now, the inside part of the rain gauge. The top part of it is that it has something like a funnel. There is a funnel whereby the water collected will be channeled into a bottle. Now, inside the rain gauge, we have a can, which is this one. And inside the can, we've got a bottle. And this bottle now will be used to collect water. So rain water or precipitation will be directed into the bottle, but if the precipitation is a lot, there will be overflow. Now, overflow from the bottle will overflow into the inner can. So when you come to measure, you will use a measuring cylinder, because there is a measuring cylinder which will be used in measuring the rainfall. So you'll measure all the water in the bottle, and if there is excess water which overflown to the inner can, now you'll start also measuring. And then you will take the total, and it will give you the total amount of precipitation. Now, if the precipitation is also a lot, and there is overflow from this inner can, it will overflow. It will go into the bottom part of it, and you are going to collect also and measure. And then at the end of the day, you are going to get the total precipitation of that particular day. There is also a lid to close the inner can, aside that. All this is actually to minimize evaporation. The purpose of putting a bottle is to minimize evaporation. The mouth of the bottle is small, so that it can also minimize surface area. And then the closing can is also to further minimize the evaporation, so that now you have a condition like such. And then this one is put inside the rain gauge. So that is about the rain gauge, and that is how to measure rainfall using rain gauge, as I have demonstrated. When you take any measurement in meteorological station, you must measure and then record. There are meteorological data recording forms whereby you enter a particular weather condition in the relevant form. So rainfall is entered in a rainfall chart or in a rainfall table, and it is normally recorded once a day. The total rainfall is once a day, and it has been standardized that the total rainfall of a particular day will be entered at 9 a.m. in the morning, and it will be for the previous day up to and if there is rain at night, it will be combined together until by 9 a.m. it will be the total rainfall, and it will be cast for the previous day. For example, today is if today is 14th, now if you record by 9 a.m. a rainfall and you get to be 20, that 20 will be put on that 10th, because it will have that rainfall is assumed to have started from maybe from 10 a.m. onwards. But if it rains before 9, it will be ended for the previous day. So that is how we can record. And then the importance of rainfall is actually we have said for agricultural purpose, and it is also for the data is used by those people who are constructing bridges and roads, because it is very important. It will help them in coming up with the proper construction material and even the timing and whatever. There are some things we said about the rain gauge. We said the rain gauge should be 30 centimeters above the ground. It is important to say, why is it 30? Why not more than that? So the important why it is 30 centimeters above the ground is to avoid what we call splashing in of rain, because the rainwater can strike the ground and then jump into the rain gauge, and which will give us false reading. And now the purpose why you put it below the ground is actually to minimize evaporation. So those things are to be observed. And when you want to set up a rain gauge also, there is what we call 4H rule. Your rain gauge should be four times the nearest object or structure near rain gauge should be four times away. Four times the height of that thing away from the rain gauge. If the structure is 10 meters, then it should be 40 meters away from the rain gauge. That is required also when you are putting up that rain gauge. To conclude, we have said that when you want to measure the rainfall of an area or precipitation of an area, you have to use a standard rain gauge. And then when you are measuring the precipitation, you use a measuring cylinder, which will be narrow and long for accuracy. And then units of precipitation or rainfall is normally millimeters. And that is the standard all over the world. Thank you.